The committee was stunned to learn that Natalia Namuli, who was allegedly paid 2.3 billion by Uganda Land Commission for over 516.2 acres of land in Kagadi, has never received any money from Uganda Land Commission and that she's not even aware of the said land. This was revealed by the CID officer attached to Parliament, Bunny Twesije, who was sent by COSASE to extract a statement from the 79-year-old Natalia Namuli in Kagadi district. According to Twesije, Namuli did not received the said 1.58 billion, neither has she ever requested for it.
Namuli stated that she had never got any money from Uganda Land Commission. Neither does she know that her in-law, Amala Peter, got any money on her behalf. Apparently, Amala Peter is the one who approached Uganda Land Commission purporting to help in the compensation of land of his mother-in-law Natalia Namuli.
Before receiving 1.58 billion, Namuli was earlier compensated 450 million over the same land. To make matters worse, Namuli is neither related to the family of the late Atwane Kalete, whose estate was compensated by Uganda Land Commission. She's not even aware of the said powers of attorney and letters of administration on which Uganda Land Commission acted to make payments.
Further narrated that at one time in the late 2020, Amala Peter brought her to Kampala and made her to sign some documents, and thereafter accommodated her in a hotel, but never explained to her the intention of the documents she was signing.
Officer Twesije disclosed to COSASE that Awan Peter Amara, a son-in-law to Namuli, was behind the fraud and the forgery that led to this fraudulent payment. He says that Namuli told him that his son-in-law duped her to sign some documents in 2020, which she was not aware of.
It is clear that Uganda Land Commission paid fraudsters who duped the old woman Natalia Namuli to sign on their documents without any knowledge of what their intentions were. This seems to have been a syndicate orchestrated by Amala Peter, some ULC officials and lawyers whose account this compensation money passed.
COSASE then turned against a one lawyer called Lubega, a partner in Lubega Buzibira and Company Advocates, a company that received the money on Namuli's behalf, and interrogated him on how they represent a person who is not aware of them to extract money from Uganda Lands Commission.
Is that money paid to this lady, Natalia?
That is what my colleague informed me, that the money was...
You are a signatory to the
yes,
account.
Yes, I am. I signed a check, mm-hmm. And once I sign a check, my colleague can walk to the bank and withdraw the money. I don't have to be there with him, Mr. Chair.
Council, we're talking about over 2 billion shillings.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Because the first payment was 450 million. The most recent one through the supplementary was 1.58 billion.
Yes, Mr.
So for you to say that I just signed and I think it was handled. This is not 200,000 shillings. It's 2 billion plus.
Transaction.
Yes.
And when they asked you to come here, you went through the file to get information that you have to submit here. On that file, did you get any receipt or any acknowledgement receipt indicating that the lady got the money?
Is it on
the file?
I didn't see one. The first time I appeared, I didn't see one. Yes, please.
And you didn't take concern? You are not concerned?
My concern would have arose from a complaint, Honorable.
No.
Yes. Council Vega can help our officers to give more information, but also to ensure that we get his partner, so that the questions he cannot respond to, because he says it is the other one, handled by the other one, I don't know. Receipt, no. Acknowledgement, no, it is the other one. He can help us in that regard through you, Chair.
COSASE discovered that the law firm forged the signature of Justice Ralph Ochan to make a court order that was used to seek for the compensation in question. The judge wrote to COSASE, distancing himself from the forgery. The court order was dated 2015, whereas the judge retired in 2013.
I also confirm that the signature on the purported letters of administration dated 18th March 2015 is most certainly not my signature. I enclose for you a copy of an instrument of appointment which I signed recently. My signature has been constant since I joined government some 40 years ago. I hope this brings to a close the utterly false and outrageous forgery of the letters of administration in question. Respectfully submitted, Justice Ralph Ochan.
However, Counsel Lubega attributed the mess to his partner Richard Buzibira, who has snubbed Kosase's summons for 2 times.
My colleague who had been handling the file asked me to sign in order to pay the client, which I did. I signed, and then he went ahead and paid the client. I wasn't physically there to acknowledge the payment because it wasn't really a requirement for me to be there, but I did sign for him, and he withdrew the money, and I believe he paid the client because I had never received any complaint.
Kosase has held Lubega, Buzibira and company advocates responsible of the forgery and fraud that caused government a loss of over 2 billion shillings and handed him over to police.
I'm going to hand you over to police because we cannot take it that for you, you are entirely innocent. I would want to establish that. Right now, I don't believe you are entirely innocent because you're a partner in this law firm.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.